asthma. Here's how to see if glutathione can help. Hi, I'm Dr. Chris Masterjohn at chrismasterjohnphd.com, and this is Chris Masterjohn Lite, where the name of the game is details, schmetails, just tell me what works. And today we're going to talk about using glutathione for asthma. Asthma is a condition of bronchoconstriction, where you have insufficient bronchodilation. And the drugs that are used to treat asthma are bronchodilators and anti-inflammatory steroids. Now, if we look at normal lung function, we have our own endogenous bronchodilator that we make. That bronchodilator is called nitrosoglutathione. It's made when glutathione, a compound that we make from the protein we eat, combines with nitric oxide. Nitric oxide and glutathione make nitrosoglutathione, and this, once formed, is our own endogenous bronchodilator. In asthma, glutathione levels are lower. In asthma, nitrosoglutathione levels are far lower in the lungs than in healthy people. And in fact, in a severe asthma attack, nitrosoglutathione levels can drop to zero. This makes me look at asthma as primarily a condition of nitrosoglutathione deficiency, which is largely driven by glutathione deficiency. When I say deficiency, I don't mean it in a technical way, like a genetic defect in where you can't make any. I just mean you don't have enough. So one of the most important things that you can do is boost your glutathione levels or your nitric oxide levels. I did a previous episode on that, and I'll link to it in the description. But today we're going to talk about using glutathione. So what I would do first, after, assuming you have good nutrition in the background, what I would do to use supplemental glutathione for asthma is, depending on whether you want to try to get faster results or you want to try to be more cost effective, I would start with either reduced glutathione supplements or liposomal glutathione supplements. If saving money but potentially taking a longer time to figure this out is of value to you, start with the reduced glutathione at 500 to 1,000 milligrams per meal. If, on the other hand, your condition is bad enough or your financial resources are good enough that you just want faster results, I would start with the liposomal glutathione. The reason is that when in doubt, I have more faith that liposomal glutathione will get to the tissues that need it. But on the other hand, I think it's quite possible that regular reduced glutathione would work, and it's a lot cheaper. If liposomal glutathione doesn't work and reduced glutathione doesn't work, then the next thing that I would try is nebulized glutathione. In order to do that, you need to see an integrative functional medicine practitioner or a doctor who specializes in respiratory disorders and ask them to offer you the nebulized glutathione. I'd make one final note that no one has proven that acetaminophen causes asthma, but we know that acetaminophen lowers glutathione levels, and there are observational studies showing that use of acetaminophen as in amounts that are more than three times or more in the past year is strongly associated with having current asthma. I don't know whether three times per year is actually the threshold at which acetaminophen might contribute to asthma. That kind of seems nuts because it's such a small amount, but I personally would err on the side of not using drugs like acetaminophen unless needed, given the potential to lower glutathione levels and the clear association of poor glutathione status with asthma. In the next episode, I'll talk about some natural nutritional things that you can do to boost your own production of glutathione. This episode is brought to you by Ancestral Supplements. Our Native American ancestors believed that eating the organs from a healthy animal would support the health of the corresponding organ of the individual. Ancestral Supplements is a nose-to-tail product line of grass-fed liver, organs, bone marrow, and more, all in the convenience of a capsule. For more information or to buy any of their products, go to ancestralsupplements.com. This episode is brought to you by Testing Nutritional Status, the ultimate cheat sheet. Everything you could ever need to know to optimize your nutrition all in one place. Easier to find and use than ever before. Get your copy at chrismasterjohnphd.com/cheat sheet. Use the code LITE5, that's all capitals, L-I-T-E, and the number 5, LITE5, to get $5 off. The audio of this episode was enhanced and post-processed by Bob Devodian of Torian Mixing. You can find more of his work at torianonlinemixing.com. All right, I hope you found this useful. Signing off, this is Chris Masterjohn of chrismasterjohnphd.com. This has been Chris Masterjohn Lite, and I will see you in the next episode.